Discovery of Printing from the American Printer by Thomas Mackellar. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. The credit of inventing the art which perpetuates the history and achievements of all the arts and sciences has been obstinately contested, several cities having advanced rival claims to the honor of the discovery. This, however, should be no matter of surprise when we consider that the inventor of a new art, unprotected by law, would naturally endeavor to conceal its processes for his own use and advantage. After due consideration, we agree with Isaiah Thomas in the opinion that the probabilities point to Laurentius, sometimes called Coster, Coster, and Custos, as the discoverer of the art of printing. Laurentius lived at Harlem and was a man of property. He seems to have been engaged in printing books from woodblocks or plates, well known to antiquaries as the block books, in which the reading matter was illustrated by rude pictures. Fragments of works so printed by him are still in existence. Among others, the celebrated Biblia Pauperum, executed between 1410 and 1420, has been attributed to him. It was only natural that his thoughts should be led to the production of single types as a means of cheapening and facilitating his work. These were first made of wood and afterward of tin. The date of his invention of separate types is given as about the year 1429. Other dates have been stated, ranging from 1422 to 1436. The first of his printed books, it is claimed, was the Speculum Humanae Salvationis, of which about 10 copies are now known to be in existence. A small primer, or abecedarium, in our opinion, shows all the marks of the first attempt of an experimenter in a new art. Coster died in 1439. The necessity for employing workmen to assist in prosecuting the art led to the divulging of the secret. Among these men, it is supposed, was John Gainsfleisch, or Gutenberg Sr., who, after learning the processes, returned to Mentz, his native place, and communicated the secret to his nephew, John Gutenberg, an ingenious artist of Strasbourg. It is in evidence that the latter, in conjunction with two partners, spent a considerable amount of money in some private experiments. These appear to have occupied several years, from 1436 to 1439, when a legal contest arose as to the rights of one of the partners, whose zealous activity had caused his death. Gutenberg continued at Strasbourg till 1444, when, his means being exhausted, he rejoined his uncle at Mentz. Here he renewed his experiments, and, needing money, he procured an introduction to John Fust, a capitalist and moneylender, who seems to have been struck with the importance of the work, and who advanced a considerable amount, all the tools and presses being pledged as security, in furtherance of the enterprise. 2 years were occupied in making the types and necessary machinery when the great work of printing the Bible was begun. There can be little doubt that, during all his years of experiment, Gutenberg had executed smaller books, one of which is surmised to have been a reproduction of the Dutch Speculum of Coster, the Donatus of 1451, the Appeal against the Turks of 1454, and the Letters of Indulgence of 1454 and 1455, all appear before the Bible, which was not published until 1455 or 1456. This great book marked an era in the art. It is painful to be told that about this time, Fust foreclosed the mortgage, and the entire work with all the materials passed into his possession. It seems, however, that Gutenberg succeeded in re-establishing a press and continued to practice the art, but produced no work at all comparable with the Bible. He died about 1468. After securing possession of the establishment, Fust engaged the service of Peter Schoeffer, who had been apprentice or assistant to Gutenberg, and who was distinguished for scholarship as well as mechanical skill. His skill and the improvements made by him in the art soon led Fust to take him into partnership, and the Bible, the Psalter, and other important works were produced. Schoeffer was further rewarded by the hand of the granddaughter of Fust. From this rapid summary, we may conclude, 1. That the merit of the invention of printing, however rude it may have been, belongs to Coaster of Harlem. 2. That Gutenberg placed the art on a permanent foundation. And 3. That its economical application was ensured by Peter Schoeffer's invention of cast metal types. It was, of course, impossible to conceal the knowledge of an art so useful to man, and within 10 years after the publication of the Great Bible, presses were established in several German cities, in Rome and other parts of Italy, and soon thereafter in France and England. William Caxton acquired a knowledge of the art in Germany and carried it into practice at Westminster in England. The year 1477 is now accepted as the date of the introduction, the first book printed with a date in England being the Dict and Sayings of the Philosophers, imprinted by me, William Caxton, at Westminster, the year of our Lord, 1477. He had previously printed without a date the Recueil of the History of Troy, which was followed by the Game and Play of the Chess, finished the last day of March, the year of our Lord God, 1474. These were, however, printed at Bruges, so, according to Mr. William Blades, the first indisputable date we have to stand on is the printing of the Dict in 1477. Though at that time over 60 years old, Caxton was notable for his industrious habit. He was possessed of good sense and sound judgment, steady, persevering, active, zealous, and liberal in his devices for that important art which he introduced into England, laboring not only as a printer, but as a translator and author. The productions of his press amount to 64. In the Church Warden's Book of St. Margaret's Parish, Westminster, his death is thus recorded. 1491. Item, at burying of William Caxton, for 4 torches, 6 shillings 8 pence. Item, for the bell at same burying, 6 pence. The Bible was printed in Spanish at Valencia in 1479 by Lambert Palmert, a German, but so completely was it afterward suppressed by the Inquisition that only 4 leaves now remain in the archives of Valencia. The first Hebrew Bible ever printed came from the press of Abraham Colorito at Soncino in 1488, a very remarkable work. Iceland had its printing office in 1530, at which a Bible was printed in 1584. End of discovery of printing. From the American Printer by Thomas MacKellar. Read by Phil Schempf.